Hey, how's it going, everybody? It's your bro, hope you're doing well, and in this video I'm going to teach you guys all about if statements in Java, so sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. One like equals one prayer for the YouTube algorithm. Alright guys and gals, in this video we're going to talk about if statements. An if statement is a very basic form of decision making. When an if statement evaluates to be true, it will perform a block of code, and that is it. Here's an example. Let's say we have a variable called maybe age. Int age equals, let's set this to 18. We can perform a block of code if some condition that we state evaluates to true. So this is how to create an if statement. We type in the word if, a set of parentheses, and then a set of curly braces. So within the parentheses of the if statement, this is the condition. We can check to see if somebody is perhaps 18 or older. So what we can do is write a condition such as age is greater than or equal to 18. Within our program, when we reach this if statement, we're going to check to see if this evaluates to be true or false. Currently, our age is set to 18. So this will evaluate to be true, and we will perform whatever is within the set of curly braces. So let's print a message such as you are an adult. And let's test this. So our age is 18, our if statement evaluates to be true, and therefore we will perform this block of code associated with this if statement, and we will display the message you are an adult. What if we change this to maybe 12? And then with our if statement, when we reach this condition, this will evaluate to be false. Therefore, we will skip this block of code as if it never even happened. We could perform a different action instead. We could write an else statement. There is no condition, we just need the word else followed by a set of curly braces. Now we are forced to take one of two actions. We will check to see if our condition is true. If it is true, we will perform this block of code. If it's false, we will instead perform this block of code. So let's print a different message. You are not an adult. So we are forced to perform one of two actions. If our condition is true, we will perform our if statement. If it's false, we will perform our else statement. And this states that you are not an adult. Now it is entirely possible to check more than one condition before reaching an else statement, and that is by using what is called an else if statement. So we type else if, a set of parentheses, and then a set of curly braces. So we can check an additional condition before reaching our else statement. So let's check to see if our age is greater than or equal to 75. All right, and then we will print a message such as, okay, boomer. So pay attention to this. Let's change our age to 75 and run this. All right, well, it displays you are an adult. That's because our if condition evaluates to true because 75 is greater than or equal to 18. So it's going to skip everything else and ignore these blocks of code and continue on with the rest of the program. So if we want to first check to see if somebody's age is greater than or equal to 75, what we can do is move this to our if statement, and I'll just switch these around and change our else if statement to 18. So we'll first check to see if somebody is greater than or equal to 75. If they are, we will first print okay boomer. Else if their age is greater than or equal to 18, we will display you are an adult. And let's try this again. And it displays okay boomer. So you can see that we got an entirely different result with these if statements. If the condition evaluates to be true, it's going to perform its own block of code and skip everything else. You can check more than one condition by adding else if statements. We could check one more thing perhaps. Else if age is greater than or equal to 13, then we can display another message such as you are a teenager. And if we changed our integer variable age to 13, this will display, you are a teenager. There is one thing that you should know. These symbols, the less than sign, the equal sign, the greater than sign, these are known as comparison operators. So they work normally as what you would imagine. However, if you want to compare if something or some value is equal, you don't use one equal sign. That's using the assignment operator. So we're attempting to assign our variable age equal to 75. If we need to compare if something is equal, we use two equal signs. So that's just one thing that is specific for programming. So we can check to see if our age is equal to 75. And this time it will print, okay, boomer. So that's all what an if statement is. It's a basic form of decision making for your program. If a condition evaluates to be true, then it will perform a block of code. If its condition is false, it will perform its else statement. Unless you have else if statements, then it's one by one going to check to see if these conditions are true before reaching the else statement. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that's the basics of if statements. If you would like a copy of all of this code, I will post this in the comments down below. And if I could ask a favor of you, I would greatly appreciate it if you smash the like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.